Hi there.
In this video, we'll be discussing the keyboard shortcuts in InDesign, so let's get started. The first one is my favorite, so with the type tool selected, double-click a word and it will be selected. Triple-click will select the entire line. Four clicks will select the entire paragraph. And five clicks will select the entire text box. The next one is to jump to a page, so hit Command J on a Mac or Control J on a PC and you get this pop-up. Enter the page number you want to jump to and hit OK, and you shall be on that page. For the next one, let's grab the rectangle tool and make a rectangle. At this point, the fill is set to black and stroke to none, as you can see on the toolbar. Hit the letter D and it shall apply the default fill, which is none, and black stroke to your shape. Hit comma and the shape will be filled with black. Hit full stop and the shape will be filled with the default gradient. Hit the forward slash key and the fill color will be set to none. Let's hit the period or the full stop key once again to fill the shape with gradient. And now when you hit the X key, it will switch between stroke and fill, so it's a toggle switch. For the next one, let's grab the type tool and make a text box and fill it with some text. Now with the text box selected, hit Command Shift and greater than key on a Mac or Control Shift and greater than key on a PC to increase the font size. Similarly, Command Shift and less than key on a Mac or Control Shift and less than key on a PC will reduce the font size. For the next one, double click the text box and select your text. Now hit Option and right arrow on a Mac or Alt and right arrow on a PC to increase kerning or character spaces. Similarly, Option or Alt and left arrow will reduce the kerning or character spaces. For the next one, let's make two more copies of this text. Now select all three lines and hit Option and down arrow on a Mac or Alt and down arrow on a PC to increase the leading or line spacing. Hitting Option or Alt and up arrow shall reduce the leading or line spacing between the lines. The next one is the toggle between paragraph formatting controls and character formatting controls. So with the text still selected, hit Command Option and 7 on a Mac or Control Alt and 7 on a PC and it toggles between the character and paragraph formatting controls. The next one is to display the center of the active page. So at the moment, the active page is the one on the left. So when I hit Command 0 on a Mac or Control 0 on a PC, it centers the active page. Similarly, when I make the page on the right my active page and hit Command 0 on a Mac or Control 0 on a PC, it centers the page on the right. And when I hit Command Option and 0 on a Mac or Control Alt and 0 on a PC, it centers the spread. The next one is to show the pages panel. On a Mac, hit Command F12, or in the latest Macs that do not have the dedicated function keys, hit Function F12 and it should do the job. For PCs, hit F12 to show the pages panel. The next one is a pretty interesting one, and I need to go to a specific page for this one. Now the image that you see here has a rectangle on top of it. Let me pull the rectangle apart to show you. Let's now put it back to cover the image. Now for some reason, if I have to delete the image, leaving the rectangle intact, I'll have to select the image first. But the problem is that the almost transparent rectangle is sitting on top of the image. So how should I select the image without moving the rectangle? All you need to do is hold Command on a Mac or Control on a PC and select the rectangle once to select it and then click once again to select what's behind the rectangle, and in our case it is the image, and then hit the delete or the backspace key and you see the rectangle is intact but the image behind it is deleted. The next one is to zoom out and move to another spread, so hold the spacebar and click and hold anywhere on the page to zoom out and you'll find a red box appearing around the spread. Now, wherever you take this red box, it will make that spread the active one. The next one is another interesting one. So when I go to the menu options, you could see that the options are not alphabetized. To alphabetize the options, hold Command Shift and Option on a Mac or Control Shift and Alt on a PC, and then go to the menu and you shall find all the options alphabetized. Another one is to switch between the preview and the edit mode, and this is a pretty easy one. So all you need to do is press the W key and the screen will transform itself to the preview mode. Hit W again to get back to the edit mode. The next one is to activate the spell checker. Oh yes, InDesign does have a spell checker much like MS Word. To activate it, all you need to do is hit Command I on a Mac or Control I on a PC and the spell checker panel shall reveal itself. The next one is to show the hidden characters, and to activate it, hit Option Command and I on a Mac or Alt Control and I on a PC, and since it's a toggle, pressing the same set of keys will hide the characters. For the last one, let's quickly jump to page 20. Let's make a text box and type in Adobe InDesign. And let's increase the font size as well. Now to turn it into outlines without visiting the menu options on top, just hit Shift Command and O on a Mac or Shift Control and O on a PC and the outlines will be created. There are way too many shortcuts to cover in a single tutorial and it's really difficult to remember all of them. So I've included a cheat sheet in the exercise files for you to go through, so do try to remember as many as you can and it shall for sure improve the workflow efficiency. Alright guys, that concludes our session and it's time for a short break, so I shall see you in the next one momentarily. Goodbye.